Now, here she is, this most delightful lady, you say. And her name is Elsie Carroll. Elsie, he said. Yes, love, I say, I'm here. And then we talk about different things, and it might sound a bit corny, but I feel in the autumn of my life I have found something very lovely in life.
I'm Keith McGowan. It's good to be with you wherever you are listening to us this morning. Welcome, you band of overnighters, our June, Inez, Elsie, Mavis, Harry, Peter, our security man, and all the rest of you. It's lovely to be with you on what is a foggy and cool Tuesday morning. Well, look, this is our overnight program, and we're together until 5 o'clock this morning. I hope you can make the full journey with us, or at least part of it. You can talk to me about anything you'd like to talk about. Whatever you like to talk about, you can talk about it with us. It's 23 minutes past 12 with Keith McGowan, and Liz is online. Morning, Liz.
Oh, good morning, Keith. I'm just ringing up about the Overnighters Club.
Yeah.
I received my number, but I just wanted to know, how do you know what functions are on and when they're on, please?
Well, we broadcast them on the radio. It has been suggested we should have newsletters and things like that, but that would sort of defeat the purpose of having people listen to the radio program.
Oh, I listen to it, but sometimes it's very difficult when you work all the time to stay awake till 5 o'clock in the morning.
Sure it is. Here's this. Is it Margaret at Reservoir?
That's me, Keith.
Hello, Mark. How are you?
I'm feeling a lot better now, thanks, Keith.
What, have you been a bit crook?
No, the last time I rang you, I was terrible distraught. I appreciate your kindness.
Oh, I remember now. That's right. I remember you were upset at the loss of your cousin back in Holland, was that right?
That's right.
Yes.
I appreciate your kindness in the overnighter.
Well, you're part of our group, Margaret. You're an important part of our group, so, you know, what you feel, we feel.
Oh, I really appreciate it. Really, you know, help me. That's what I needed. Just needed someone to talk to at the time.
Well, you know, we're always here.
And I had a distressing time Sunday. I had a beautiful day on Saturday with Iris from Epping.
Didn't you go the footy?
Yes, I went with Iris. We went, we had a beautiful day, but Sunday morning I got up and my budgie died. Rotten bird, had to go and die on me.
Very inconsiderate of it, wasn't it?
No, I picked the right time, didn't it?
Oh, yes, through Keith's overnighters. Which started as something very small, and I remember when he got to about 200 or 250. You know, that it was a big deal, and now there's thousands and thousands. And the regular outings and the weekly gatherings, at whether it's at McDonald's at Nunawading or a hotel somewhere, has brought thousands of people together who, apart from this club, would never have met. And there's obvious friendships have been formed. By listening of a night time, you hear that people go and stay, you know, an elderly lady will go and stay at another lady's home for a couple of nights, or even the younger ones. It's not just for geriatrics, it's, you know, it covers a wider spectrum than that. And
happy birthday to me, happy birthday to me, happy birthday dear Beryl. Happy birthday to me.
Beryl's birthday today. Congratulations.
Hey, that's all I rang.
Oh, that's lovely. What are you doing for your birthday, Beryl?
Nothing.
The dreamer and lover are always in tears. The clown spends life with a smile. Sorry, the life with a smile isn't... I'm sorry, I just whack up. I'll start again. Life is a play,
and we all play a part. The lover, the dreamer, the clown. The dreamer and lover are always in tears. The clown spreads sunshine around. The life with a smile is a lot.
It's filled in a lot of things for me that my mind is kept alert and that I'm in touch with people, and it gives me something to think about, a lot to think about, not something, a lot to think about. But I really don't think that you know who you are talking to, because there's a lot of silent listeners that don't ring up. Keith monitors the calls that he has a dump button, and he can, if there's any bad calls, well, he can stop it immediately. So we have no worries about that. It's one great happy sort of family talkback.
Take this one out, put this one in, and Bob's your own.
And here's the moment that many people are literally hanging on for. This is the time of the morning when I open up the telephone and one of the most listened to voices that you'll ever hear comes chirping through as she says,
"Hello, Martha." Oh, you're delightful, you are. How did you guess, my love? Of yours.
Oh dear, Elsie at Thomastown.
Thank you, my love.
This is the love of my life.
Am I now?
You know you are.
Well, that's just wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
I listen to him and look forward to listening to him. From 12 o'clock till 5. And sometimes I fall asleep.
Would you have time to listen to a very short story about a train?
Yes.
I'll read it out to you if you like.
Okay.
A long time ago, there was a boy living in a small town in the Dandenongs. He was sad boy who didn't have many other...
And this is something to all the overnighters, how to enjoy life. First of all, really look at nature and what God has given to you. Go to the gardens, look at the animals, the children playing. Stop and think what a wonderful world God has given us.
I'm very nervous, Keith. What an adventure this boy was having to be able to ride in the engine compartment of the train and see the fireman stoke the fire with his huge shovel. But as with all good adventures, they don't last forever, and after 2 hours, they were back at Belgrave, and the boy's mother was waiting for him. He waved and shouted to her as they stopped. That boy is now grown up, but every time he hears a steam whistle blow, he still remembers his childhood dream that came true.
Ivan?
Yes?
Were you that boy?
That's right. Yeah, I wrote that in now. I'm sorry, Keith. I'm very sorry. I wrote that in memory of my mother. I'm a 43 boy too, same as you.
We're the same age, mate.
Yeah, and I just had to tell you about this.
And gee, I'm glad you did, Ivan. I'm real glad you called this morning. It's, that was a lovely story, and well presented, and it's very easy to understand why you would feel as you do. Thanks for calling, Ivan.
Thanks very much, Keith.
Good luck, mate.
All right.
Bye.
Right.
1278 3AW, I'm Keith McGowan.
Just in your vestie laguba, be a palliacho laugh, clown, laugh.
Is this too long?
Just keep singing for us, Audrey.
Off into the world we go, planning futures, sharing years. The world and all its solitary, all our wisdom disappears.
That was terrific. Congratulations.